So a few days ago, we got the scoop on the Galaxy S25 Ultra, spilling the beans on how the new Orion cores in the Snapdragon 8 Gen 4 were hitting over 10,000 points on Geekbench. That's a first for a smartphone chip. Now, additional details have surfaced, indicating that the Galaxy S25 Ultra could pull off something no other Android phone has managed to do so far. You see, we all know Apple's been ruling the chip scene for ages with its A-series chips. But lately, things have been getting interesting. This year, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 finally caught up in CPU performance, but only in multi-core scores. When it comes to single core, Apple's still way ahead of the game. But hold on to your hats, because things might be about to change with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 4. Word on the street, or rather from a report out of Korea, suggests this powerhouse of a chipset could outshine Apple's A18 Pro, which is set to debut in the iPhone 16 Pro Max. And get this, not just in multi-core, but in single-core performance too. According to the leaks, the 8 Gen 4 is expected to boast an impressive single-core score of 3500 in a Geekbench 6 test, surpassing the reported 3300 single-core score of Apple's A18 Pro. In the multi-core arena, the 8 Gen 4 is rumored to score an impressive 10,628, while the 18 Pro is set to hover around 8,200 mark. Again, this marks the first time a Snapdragon chip has outperformed an Apple A-series chip in single-core performance, and this is huge. Now, you might be wondering why Qualcomm is making such a big leap in performance while Apple's upgrades seem kinda meh. Well, there are three big reasons for it. First, the 8 Gen 4 is jumping from 4nm to 3nm, while the 18 Pro is sticking to the same 3nm tech. Switching to a new node brings a ton of performance boosts and efficiency gains, so that's a big factor. Second, Qualcomm is using Orion cores for the 8 Gen 4, which are developed by former Apple engineers responsible for Apple's powerful M-series chips. It's like having the competition secrets on your side. Third, the 8 Gen 4 is rumored to hit a peak clock speed of 4.3 GHz, way higher than the A18 Pro. Now, you might think this means the 8 Gen 4 won't be as efficient, but that's not the case. It's achieving these cores with just 8 watts of power compared to its predecessor's 11 watts. So both Qualcomm and Samsung seems to have a winner on their hands. With the Galaxy S25 Ultra, we might finally see an end to Apple's long reign in chip dominance, something they've loved to boast about for years. Moving on, it's been a couple of months since the S24 lineup hit the shelves, and we've got the sales data for this period. As for the findings from Counterpoint Research, the global sales of the S24 series have shown an 8% increase compared to the S23 since its launch. Notably, in South Korea, it's 22% higher. In Western Europe, it's up by a whopping 28%. And in the US, the increase is by 14%. The S24 Ultra is stealing the show, making up 52% of the total sales. Oh, and speaking of sales, Apple pulled up something pretty surprising and put an end to Samsung's 14-year streak. Curious to know what I'm talking about? Click here, and I'll see you there.